Okay, and this is air conditioner airflow. Okay, so the first one is, why did we choose this project? We chose this project because we want to know how the steam line will be in the air conditioner, and how about more than one conditioner, how the steam will be like, and the orientation for and the orientation to install the air conditioner for its best efficiency. So the second one is the factor that make the air conditioner have more efficiency. The first one is lifetime to use the air conditioner machine. The second one is ratio of the air conditioner comparing to the room size. This is bigger or the smaller to have the cooler temperature. The third one is position to install the air. And the last one is dust inside the air conditioner. So about our control variable in this CFD project, we have loom dimensional parameter which in unit meter. The length of the loom is about 4 meter with the width about 3.65 and height of 6 meter. On the air conditioner dimensional parameter, which in unit of meter, we have length of 0.5 meter with 1.5 meter and height of 0.65 meter. And the air conditioner position in meter, we choose is to have it height from the base about 2.7 meter, and velocity of each case we divide to 3 cases. The case 1 is 0.78 meter per second, and about case 2 and 3 is both same about 0.39 meter per second. The temperature of this situation will be the same in the degree Celsius of 40 degrees Celsius. Not only wall but also everywhere, just base, floor, wall, everything is 40 degrees Celsius. The air temperature in the inlet point of the air conditioner in degrees Celsius is about 20 degrees Celsius.
So now we're gonna talk about our process. So first, our process, we're gonna create the three room using the Cartier V5 as with the parameter that we said before. So our first room is there are gonna be only one air conditioner with 0.799 airspeed bit and face amps attached into the one side of the wall. And the second room, you have two air conditioner attached in the both side of the wall, not facing into each other. And our third room will kind of similar like our second room, but the airflow will flow into the floor. So after we create the structure, we insert our Cartier into this CFD program. And next, we're gonna do the meshing. So we generate mesh, we didn't change that much from the default. We only change the minimum size to 0.01 meter because of our computer problem. So next we're gonna do our setup. So first we're gonna enable the energy equation into the on, because we're gonna see how the temperature change inside the room. And also we use the viscous as the standard epsilon. And next we're gonna enable the gravity to see how the airflow effect from the gravity. And we're gonna insert the inlet velocity and inlet temperature. And also we're gonna insert the environment temperature as 40 degrees. And also we're gonna insert the heat transfer coefficient of the wall to see how the temperature outside affect inside the room too.
Okay, after we set up, as Ming said, we will get the results and we compute the solution from the CFD program. We can see that the graph is tend to move down slightly, and then we will move steady for a while after they left the air condition. Then for the first case, then we got only one air condition. You can see that the flow will tend to move forward with high velocity to the edge of the room, but it could not totally move along the entire part of the room. As you can see the line, it will move like a circular motion and without the speed in the middle of the room. For the first case, you can see that the temperature is quite high on the other side of air condition, but in the middle of the room, the temperature is quite low than other part. For the pressure, like in Bernoulli's equation say that if it got high velocity, the pressure will very low, but if it got a low velocity, the pressure is high. So that you can see that the pressure at the back of the air condition with airspeed is quite low, it's quite higher than other part that the wind from the air is blow to. For the second case with two air condition, you can see that the streamline of this case is quite blow around the entire room as it have two air condition. The air is blow and contact with each other and create separate flow in the middle of the room, so that the airflow of from the air condition can move through around the entire room. And for the temperature, for this case, with heating is quite the best solution to make the entire room cold. You can see that in the middle of the room and totally like all every part is quite got a low temperature around here, which is quite great for our expectation. And then for the pressure gap, same like in first case, in the place that behind the air condition it got high pressure due to the low velocity, and in the middle is quite low pressure because of the steam line that flow into the in the middle of the room. And then the third case is same, it's like two air condition, but we change that, we move the air inlet downside and outlet in the side. You can see that the air flow is blow directly toward the floor and create steam line that could not totally move to entire room, but it's better than case one. The airflow totally have a high velocity under the air condition, but in the middle of the room is only a slow blow of a wind. For this case, the pressure is quite totally high on the upper side of air condition due to the blow of the wind is totally moved down, so on the upper they got a high pressure due to very low speed. But on the ground you can see that there only a less pressure due to the high velocity of the air blow. But for the temperature, you can see that total is can be divided into two parts here, because for the air blow from the air condition, the flow got contact with each other and create separation, which create not totally equal temperature of the room because of the air blow, so it make one side will be totally cooler than other sides. To conclude, from three cases, we can conclude that on the case 2 is quite the best position for air location to make the entire room cold, better than case 1 that could not cover all the area, and case 3 that temperature in the room will not totally same with other places. So case number 2 is the best.